Chapter fractions. A fraction represent an equal part of a whole. Means 1, 1.5, 1/4, we have 1/4. This is like that. So a fraction represent an equal part of a whole. A proper fraction, as you all have learned in class 3 and 4. So let's revise this quickly. A proper fraction has the numerator less than the denominator. 2 by 3, 3 by 5. So upper side you have numerator and lower side you have denominator. So proper fraction has the numerator less than the denominator. An improper fraction has the numerator greater than the denominator. Means upper side number 5 by 4. That is, numerator is greater than the denominator. Like fractions have the same denominator. 5 by 8, 1 by 8, 3 by 8. As in all three fractions, we have same number 8. So these are like fractions. Unlike fractions have different denominator. Like 4 by 5, 3 by 2, 1 by 6. Here we have 5, 2, 6 different numbers. So these are called unlike fractions. Now here, unit fractions have only 1 as a numerator. 1 by 4, 1 by 2, 1 by 3. So here numerator is 1 in all these three fractions. So these fractions are called unit fractions. Next we have equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions have the same value even though the numerator and denominator are different. Here we have 1 by 2 and 5 by 8. Now if we divide 5 ones are 1, 5 twos are 10. So we have same value. 5 by 10, if we reduce this fraction, it will be 1 by 2. Again 1 by 4 and 2 by 8. 2 ones is the 2, 2 fours is the 8. So again when we reduce 2 by 8, its value is 4. It means that equivalent fractions have the same value even though the numerator and denominator are different. Now last we have mixed fraction. Mixed fraction is a combination of a whole number and a proper number. 5 whole number 1 by 4. So value of this is, we have to do 4 multiply by 5 plus 1. 4 5s are 20 plus 1, 21 by 4. 6 3s are 18 plus 2, 20 by 6. So mixed, if we have mixed fraction, we have to take value like that. 5 multiply by 4 plus 1. So these are called mixed fractions. These are called mixed fractions. So now once again I want to repeat. We have proper fraction, improper fraction. Then we have like fractions, unlike fractions, unit fractions, equivalent fractions and mixed fractions. Let's do some exercise related to these. Express the following improper fraction as a mixed fraction. 32 by 5, 29 by 4, 49 by 6. So 32 divided by 5. We have 6. Then 2, we have 2 remainder. So remainder is numerator. Whatever the quotient is, that is your whole number. And this is denominator. So the mixed fraction is 6 whole number 2 by 5. Here 29 divided by 4. So 4 sevens are 28. Remainder is 1. So the mixed fraction is 7 whole number 1 by 4. Now 49 divided by 6. So 6 eights are 48, remainder 1. So 8 whole number 1 by 6. So whenever we have improper fraction, we divide it and then whole number will be quotient, and lower side numerator, remainder is numerator and divisor is denominator. Next question is, express the following mixed number as improper fractions. So here we have 5 whole number, 7 denominator, 2 as in. So what to do? 7 multiply by 5 plus 2. This is the way, here multiplication, here plus. 7 multiply by 5 plus 2. 7 5s are 35 plus 2, 37 by 7. So the answer is mixed fraction, we have 37 by 7. Again do it here. 8 multiplied by 4 plus 3. 8 multiplied by 4 plus 3. 8 fours are 24. 24 and 3, 27 by 8. This is the mixed improper fraction. Why it is improper fraction? We have to convert mixed fraction. This is called mixed fraction and this is called improper fraction. Improper fractions means numerator is greater than denominator. So here we have 27 by 8. Answer is 27 by 8. Now next we have 3 whole number 4 by 9. This is mixed fraction. So into and plus. 9 threes are 27 plus 4. 28, 29, 30, 31. So we have 31 by 9. So the answer is 31 by 9. Improper fraction means numerator is greater than denominator. Next question is reduce the following fractions to the lowest term. 25 by 35, 42 by 48, 60 by 72. So what to do? First we will take the lowest prime number, one number which is divisible by both the number. So here 5 is in the ones place, 5 is in the ones place. It means that both numbers are divisible by 5. So here we have 5 by 7. So the answer is 5 by 7. 5 by 7. Now here we have 42 by 48. So even number. So both the numbers are divisible by 2. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. 21, then 24. Now what to do? Now we have to see the number which exactly divisible by. Now this number is divisible by 3. This is divisible by 3. Divide by 3, divide by 3. So here we have 7 by 8. So we have answer is 7 by 8. Next we have again even number. Means both the numbers are divisible by 2. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. 30 upon 36. Then what to do? Divide by 2 once again. We have 15, 18. Now 3. Next number is 3, lowest prime number. Both the numbers are divisible by 3. So we have 5 by 6. The answer is 5 by 6.